ตวิญญาณตัวลายมีสองเป็นตัวมีสิ่งมากกว่าเราจะปล่อยเพื่อให้เป็นวันบริษัทเป็นท็อปที่ของสิ่งเป็นรายผู้จัดการสิ่งมากกว่าท็อปที่จะเป็นโชว์และวิชาการเอาจริงมาพูดกับท่าน
เมื่อ meditate alone at home or with the others meditators in the meditation center.But sitting meditation is pay attention.To ourselves, what do we are meditating with the others? How do?Others, meditators, or yogis in this Dhamma hall, we have to meditate by ourselves. We have to be mindful to ourselves.In sitting, standing, walking, and lying down posture, we have to meditate by ourselves. We don't need to pay attention to the others.When we are mindful in our daily life, we have to practice by ourselves. No need to pay attention to the others.When we speak, we must pay attention to the other person. When we are reading, we must pay attention to the.Story or event. That's why it is difficult to be mindful in both speaking and reading. we are not used to do like this. That's why it is difficult. To be able to be mindful while we are speaking, we must be very skillful in our practicing meditation. If we are not expert to be mindful ourselves, we will not be able to be mindful while we are speaking or reading. Mindfulness is necessary to be mindful while we are speaking. If we are not used to be mindful, the speed of mindfulness will be very slow because of not enough practice. A lot of practice is necessary to fasten the speed of our mindfulness. Mindful while we are speaking is also very difficult for me. That's why I stop speaking and go to the retreat. During the 10 days retreat, I have to meditate very intensively. Because of intensive practice, the power of mindfulness became higher, and then when I came back from the retreat, I can be mindful to my why I'm speaking. To be skillful mindfulness in speaking and reading, we must practice a lot. Everything is possible if we can make enough effort. Have never been practiced Nidha Bhavana intentionally. I have never been taught to practice Nidha Bhavana also. Only by practicing meditation, I came to understand step by step changing of my mind. When my anger became less and less, loving kindness appear naturally. I need to learn a lot from Buddha. If I have a chance, I will continue to learn. No one is complete or perfect except Devota. We all should practice one good practice after another, not only for ourselves, but also for everyone. when I was far, far away from the meditation practice, meditators in meditation center, I don't know about my mind and attachment. Only when I had a chance to go to the meditation center and to meditate, I came to understand mind is the most important. If we learn the teaching of the Buddha, we can understand about our mind. But if we are not practicing the teaching of the Buddha, we cannot be free from attachment. In the society, to follow the middle way by ourselves may not be impossible for most of us. Most of my teachings intend to the people who are far away from Buddha teaching. Only a few people with little attachment and high intelligence may not need the help of the surrounding or environment. In my experience, most of the meditators are lay person. So I have to teach a lot to the lay person with their family. Most of the people have a lot of attachment. I myself also practice meditation as a layman. For the lay people to abandon the attachment may be difficult. So also, everything is difficult for the lay people. If we follow the middle way, it will be difficult. So also, if we teach the middle way to the other people, it will also be difficult. Even our life may be a series of difficulty. We cannot escape from the difficulty. That's why we should choose the middle way. If we follow the other way, it will never end. Only the middle way has the end. The end of the middle way may be the end of all the difficulties. If I do not believe in the middle way, I will not teach about the middle way. I am teaching the middle way to the lay person, because I know lay person can also follow the middle way. If I do not believe like this, I will not teach to the lay person. Last 7 years ago, I met a young girl who is with her family. She's just over 20 at that time. she is with her husband and with her small son. She was running her own business at that time. Although she is too young and too busy with her family and with her job, she is intelligent. Although she cannot go to the meditation center, she practices in her daily life. Sometimes she used to come and ask me about the meditation practice. At that time, I have not established my own meditation center. I have to teach at the Dhamma Hall only in the morning. Sometimes she used to come and meditate in my morning teaching. She can follow the middle way. She is very amazing. After 1 year later, she can even help me to teach in my meditation center. Her name is Syama Chinyamnu. To abandon attachment in family life may be difficult, but it is possible if we try enough. We should abandon all our doubts and we should follow the middle way. If there is a strong will to follow the middle way, there will also be a way for everyone. To be using only, we must be free from attachment to our eyes, to the physical object to be seen, and also to seeing. we must also be free from misunderstanding of something to the eyes, to the object, and to the seeing. In this way, doing or looking, maybe doing only, and also seeing, maybe seeing only. If there is misunderstanding of me or mine or you, it will not be doing only, seeing only.